Hi, my dear students. I hope you have learned the lessons that we had for the first week or the module one, and I hope you get the idea of why is empowerment technologies offered as a subject in the senior high school curriculum. Well, as you all know, empowerment technology deals with technologies. And like what I have said in our group chat, this subject is being offered, or this course is being offered to you, senior high school students, so that you will become a responsible citizens of the internet, or what we call now to become a responsible netizens. And of course, to become a responsible netizens, you have to take note of the following responsibilities, especially when it comes to the internet. And pag sinabi nating internet, that is also synonymous to the social media networks or social media platforms that we are using now or that are available now. So, kailangan matutunan ninyo itong mga different lessons that will make you, okay, hopefully, before the end or habang natutunan nyo mga lessons ngayon, may nagbabago sa inyo. That is why, kung mapapansin ninyo, I am starting to teach you to become responsible netizens by following our rules, okay? Our rule in our group chat, not to comment, not to talk about anything else, but to talk only about academics. And that's part of being a responsible netizen. Because you opt to follow, okay? Nagfa-follow kayo sa kung ano man ang makabubuti, okay? Sa internet, alright? Now, this is now on, still on the quarter one. And the next topic, or the module two, is on online safety, security, ethics, and etiquette. I'm sure for most of you, akala nyo, feeling nyo, first time nyo malalaman, matututunan itong topic na ito or itong lesson na ito. But it's not. Okay? Marami ng mga cases, marami ng mga examples that we have witnessed in Facebook alone, in the social media alone. Ang dami ng mga ganito na mga examples na nakita natin, na akala natin hindi part lang siya ng internet, part lang siya ng social media, but it is part now of what we call now our subject, which is empowerment technologies. In your module, you will see that the part where it asks you what you need to know for this topic. Okay, so it is here to help you master. This topic is here for you to master online safety, security, ethics, and etiquette. So marami yan, okay? You have to know what are the different online safety measures, the different security measures, the ethics and the etiquette, which is very, very, very important that you have to have, okay? Habang kayo ay, not habang, talagang kailangan ma-develop natin yan, ma-develop nyo yan. Right? So I hope you will all learn this by, of course, this video, with the help of this video, and with the help of your module, which you're reading now. Now, after going through this module, you are expected to, of course, ito na yung mga activities na gagawin nyo in the module that you have. So, first, name the various online threats, identify the online safety measures, and consider one's and others' reputation when using the internet. Now, from the previous lesson, you have learned, I hope you have learned, the three versions of the web technology. So meron tayong tinatawag na web 1.0, which is the static, okay? Web 2.0, web 3.0, right? So web 1.0 is what you call static because there's only one activity that you can do, which is only reading, purely reading. Nung panahon namin, when the internet is just new, okay, ang activity lang na pwede namin gawin sa mga websites that we have is only to read. Magbabasa lang kami. Kukuha lang kami ng information from that, okay, or from those websites, okay? Wala na kaming ibang pwedeng gawin kundi magbasa lang, okay? But with the advancement of technology, meron na tayo ngayong tinatawag na Web 2.0, which is interacting naman na, alright? Bakit siya naging interacting? Because you have more than one activity that you can do aside from reading. And that is, you can now comment. Pwede ka na mag-comment. Pwede ka na magbigay ng opinion mo. Pwede ka na magsulat ng pwede mong sabihin. Okay? And other than that, pwede ka mag-like. Pwede ka mag-share. Pwede kang you can do whatever. You can email them directly from that website. Okay? You can message them if you want. Okay? So that is the activity, and that is why the difference of Web 1.0 to 2.0, a version of a higher and a bigger and a better version of the 1.0. Okay, and then this 3.0 is, of course, it is available now, and it is being used now, but still on the process of developing it. Kasi nga, the thing is, kapag i-incorporate ka agad nila ang Web 3.0, baka kasi the tendency is baka mag-crash yung ating websites or ating www. Okay? So, unti-unti ini-incorporate na sa ating internet, sa ating websites or webs, itong tinatawag na Web 3.0. Now, kung tatanong niyo ako, ano yung example that we can have, that we have for the Web 3.0? Meron tayo niyan. Okay? Hindi niyo lang napapansin, pero the best example that we can give for the Web 3.0 is what you call now the Lazada. Okay? Na-experience niyo na ba ang mag-shopping sa Lazada? Kung mapapansin niyo, or even in Shopee, di ba? Kung mapapansin niyo, there is the home page of the Lazada or the web, the Shopee, na kung saan mapapansin mo na kung ano yung mga brinouse mo from that applications from Lazada and Shopee, yun yung mga available sa home page, di ba? Yun yung mga available na andun yung mga, mapapansin mo, magugulat ka na andun lahat yung mga things na when search mo from Lazada or Shopee. Okay, same is true also from Facebook, kasi kapag nag browse ka sa Lazada, ang may mga tendency or may parang review ang Facebook na meron silang pinipin sa wall natin, not in the wall, in the news feed, na kung saan andun yung brinouse natin from Lazada. Diba? So, yun yung example ng 3.0. Because the idea of 3.0 is to take note, yung idea ng 3.0 is to remember yung mga choices na brinouse mo, yung mga gustong-gusto mong tignan, yung mga gustong-gusto mong makita, okay? Yun yung pinipin nila as part of that in our news feed, okay? So the best example that we can give for the Web 3.0 is what you call now the Facebook and Lazada and even Shopee. Okay? Because it remembers our choices. Yun yung pinaka-idea at pinaka-purpose ng ating web 3.0, okay? Para hindi ka na mahirapan na hanapin yung mag-type, okay? Hindi ka na mahirapan na alalahanin kung ano yung gusto mong i-search, okay? Because the 3.0 will provide you that, okay? Further, okay, it is also said that the world of ICT continues to evolve, and that is true, okay? Kaya nga kung mapapansin ninyo, ang laki ng pinagbago ngayon ng technology, especially now in the what we call the new normal, okay? You may not understand and you may not feel that because you are modular, but most of the students that we have in our country alone feel that change, big change, and evolve, yung nag-evolve yung internet natin ngayon. And the industry has developed several innovations that cater to the needs of the people, whether it is for business or personal use, okay? Kaya nga mapapansin nyo, ang dami-dami-dami mga applications, ang dami-dami mga websites na bago ngayon, especially now na more ang gamit ng internet. Well, mas malaki din naman ang gamit ng internet, pero trumiple, naging quadruple pa nga, if may say, yung gamit ng internet ngayon. Okay? So, these trends in ICT in today's generation focuses on technological convergence, social media, and mobile technologies, and even assistive media. Okay? Malalaman nyo kung ano mga ito sa mga susunod na modules ninyo. So, the internet has radically changed the way people interact with the world, especially now. Okay? They have accounts on different online platforms, and some have unlimited internet access, and some are active users of the web also. Okay? But, we have to remember that online safety or internet safety is also an emergent concern, okay? Especially for children. I will give you an example afterwards na magugulat kayo na it's a threat pala in our security, right? So the lesson 2 is on online safety, security, and ethics and etiquette, okay? It says here that the internet truly is a powerful tool, no doubt, okay? Internet is a powerful tool, lalong-lalo na ngayon sa sa current life that we have now, okay? Sa current situation na meron tayo ngayon, it's very powerful. And hindi na siya just want eh. It's a need. Okay? Naging need na siya. It can be used to promote your business like what we are doing now. Okay? I myself is an example of this. I promote my businesses through the internet. Okay? And then, and kung mapapansin ninyo, this is the sad thing naman about internet, in the business world, that most of the companies, most of the big companies all over the world shut down because of this pandemic. And bakit? Hindi lang dahil sa pandemic, dahil mas ginagamit na ang internet kaysa sa physical store. But what I mean is that ang mga tao ngayon, more na ang pagsha-shopping nila sa internet. Gusto na nila ng click, and then buy, and then pay na. Ganun lang yun. Okay? Mas gusto na nila ngayon yun. Natatakot na silang lumabas ngayon, especially now. Okay? So, ang daming mga nag-shutdown, ang daming mga nag-close, ang daming mga naluging mga negosyo because most of the people are on online stores na. Okay? And much more, may free delivery pa, di ba? Meron pa mga delivery, bayaran mo na lang yung parang price ng, how do you call this? Yung price ng pamasahe mo sana, di ba? So, mas makakatipid ang mga tao. So, ang dami talagang nagsara because of this online selling. Okay? It can also be used to gain new friends, of course. Okay? Pero ingat lang tayo. Okay? Mag-ingat lang tayo. I hope hindi tayo yung mga gustong magpasikat lang, gustong maging sikat lang, okay? Remember, afterwards, we shall discuss this one. Okay, mayroon tayong example dyan. Stay in touch with the old ones or with the old friends, okay? And it is also a source of entertainment through games. So, ang daming mga ganyan ngayon. Ang daming mga baliw na baliw, adik na adik sa ML, okay? Mobile Legends, and some other games, okay? Online communities and everything in between and others, okay? But most like, but like most things in the world, okay, there's always other side of the coin. Ibig sabihin, the internet daw is one of the dangerous places, especially if you do not know what you're doing with it. So kung hindi mo alam, you are ano to, immature, okay, hindi ka responsible user, you don't know your boundaries in using the internet. The internet can be one of the most dangerous places that you can be. Okay? Mas dangerous pa sa pumunta sa Tondo. Mas dangerous pa na pumunta sa lugar na maraming NPA or maraming mga terorista. Okay? But there's no need for you to worry because it is never that late. Kaya nga meron tayong tinatawag na empowerment technologies so that you will learn, okay, what you need to learn in this generation that we have, okay? Now, we have here the different information which are maybe a risk, okay, maybe a threat to you, to us, okay, if we will not manage it well, okay? So, first, what type of information? First, we have the first name. Your first name. Bakit merong risk dyan? There's a risk in sharing your first name. Chances are a hacker already knows plenty or stuff about you even if you only give out your first name. You cannot just walk in a room and start introducing yourself to everyone. You do not know whom you can come across with. Okay? But there's no need to worry kasi kung hindi ka naman, kung wala kang kaaway, kung walang nag-trip sa'yo, kung walang galit sa'yo, okay, that will not be a point of risk. Pero yun nga, sabi, it can be a risk, okay, especially if there's a hacker, okay, especially kung famous ka and ano to, gusto nilang gayahin yung personality mo, gusto nilang gayahin yung content mo, okay? It's a risk also, okay? The next, last name. If sharing your first name is a small risk, having both your first and last is more risky. That is why, sabi nga nila, it would be good if you only select and add your real friends in Facebook. Okay? Huwag tayong basta-bastang nag-add ng mga friends na hindi naman natin kilala because yan nga, there's a risk for your first name, for your last name. Okay? Especially ito, middle name. Ito ang pinaka-wag ninyong isa-share in your Facebook account or in your social media accounts. Okay? Your middle name. Kasi nga, in most of the government transactions, kailangan yung middle name mo. Okay? Lahat, not only government transactions, even private transactions, yung pagbukas ng account sa bank, pag-retrieve ng email mo, kailangan ng middle name. Okay? So sharing your middle name is probably not the most risky of this shared information, but sharing your entire full name would be. Okay? So, meron ka nang first name, meron ka nang middle name, meron ka pang last name, ay, grabe na. Talagang at risk ka na. Especially kung meron kayong kaya, especially if people know that meron kayong mayaman kayo, okay? You are at risk of this, okay? Current and previous schools also. Most people who steal identities and study their subject, okay? They can use this information to verify or for verification purposes, okay? Ayan. So, yung kung saan kayo galing na school, kung saan kayo graduate na school, okay, delikado rin yan. Your cellphone number, okay lang maglagay ng cellphone number sa Facebook, but make sure naka-customize siya. It is only seen by you. But, kung negosyante ka naman at meron kang negosyo, you can give your number, okay? Provided, meron ka pang isa pang personal na number talaga, right? Who your mother and father are, okay? Ayan na yun, okay? Risky, yet not as risky as posting their full name, especially your mother's maiden name. Oh, yan. Yung mother's maiden name, kailangan yan when transacting in government transactions, even in private transactions, kailangan yan sa lahat ata. Lahat actually ng transactions mo, kailangan mo ng mother's maiden name. Okay, so don't ever complete the name of your mother and father, okay? Or, kung hindi naman kailangan itag sila, don't tag them na, okay? Who your siblings are, okay? There's a huge risk also, especially if you have younger siblings. Strangers may pretend or use their identity to dupe you, okay? Gagayahin, okay? Even your address. Hopefully, you answered no to this one. Okay, giving the internet your number is one thing. Giving them your address is a whole other level. It would be much easier for criminals to find you also. Okay, so yun yung nakakatakot. Your home phone number, okay, is also a risk. Okay, this shared information is more risky than sharing your personal phone number. Scams usually use this information to deceive you, okay? And what one of which is when a stranger pretends to know your parents or pretends to know you. Ayan, so delikadong-delikado if you will put your home phone number. And of course, your birthday. Okay lang maglagay ng birthday, but huwag ka maglagay ng birth year mo. The month and the date, pwede lang yun. Okay? Letting people know your birthday is probably a must if you want to get as many gifts as possible. Pampang gifts talaga. But having it in your profile makes you vulnerable to identity theft. Okay? So, yun yun. Okay? Others will make another account and copy everything about you, which is now what's called the identity theft, right? All right, I'll give you this example, okay? Alam ko ang daming sa inyong mga nakakita na ng ganito at itong mga different challenge na ito, okay? May panganib na dala, it says here, may panganib na dala ang pagpo-post ng picture ng inyong anak sa social media, okay? Dahil dyan, okay, one victim of this is itong si Amanda, where, I don't know kung sino yung nakakita sa anak niya, but it was, the picture of the daughter was placed in a porn site, okay, in a porn, in a pornography group, okay, at the pedophile group, okay, itong pedophile, ito yung mga kalalakihan na gustong-gustong makipagtalik sa mga bata or even baby. O, yun yung sinasabi natin. Okay? Kaya nakakatakot. Okay? May isang website ang kumuha sa tatlong picture ng kanyang anak, okay, na si Kalia. Ginamit ang picture ng kanyang anak sa pinakamasahol na pamamaraan. Ayan. Inedit yung picture ng anak at nilagyan ng heavy makeup. Ayan na. Ayan yung sinasabi natin. Okay? So, dahan-dahan tayo sa pagkikijoin natin sa mga challenge na yan. Especially if it will damage or it will be used against us. So, before we join any challenge in the social media, pag-isipan muna natin, will you be safe if you will do that? Hindi ka ba manganganib dyan or even your family members? hindi ba sila at magiging at risk diyan? So we have to be very careful, right? Ayan. Kailan ba nauso itong TikTok na ito? Itong pandemic lang to eh. Okay? There's a call noon to delete TikTok, okay? Because ang sinasabi nila, there's a Chinese-based social media app, okay? Itong TikTok is a Chinese-based social media app, which is called a malware, okay? What is this malware? Malalaman niya mamaya, okay? By the group Anonymous, as it urges the public to delete the app to avoid further security issues. So, may mga ipoprovide ka kasi mga information when you join a TikTok, the TikTok application. Meron ka ibibigay ng mga information and it says to be, ang unang umalya dito is the US, USA. Kasi nga, alam nyo naman na magkaaway ang China and USA. At ayaw, itong USA ay galit sa mga China because, sa China because they think na kinakopya or they are threat in their national security. So, doon sila, kaya sila, ang unang-unang umalya sa TikTok na ito. Okay? The malware mamaya will be discussed in a short while. Okay? The internet is defined as the information superhighway. Okay, before it, nung college kami, we use, wala kaming internet, there's an internet, pero limited ang information that you can get from it. So, you really need to go to the library. Kailangan mag-library ka, pumunta ka talaga sa library at magbasa, basahin mo. Ano? You go there every free time, okay? Kasi kung hindi, kawawa ka. Okay? Kawawa yung estudyante. And this information, this means that anyone has access to this highway and can place information and can grab that information. This is why social networking sites are like Facebook continue to improve their security measures. The threat to cybercrime is really very real. Totoong-totoo ang cybercrime. And whatever information we share today can affect our future. So, this is very true. Mag-ingat tayo. Okay? Ingatan natin yung ating mga sarili. Okay? Alright, so there's a tip. Okay? We have tips here to stay safe online first. Be mindful of what you are what you share online and what site you share into it. Okay, so dapat mag-ingat tayo sa sinishare natin sa online at yung sinishare yung site na sinishare natin. Okay, mag-ingat din tayo doon. Alright, do not just accept terms and conditions. Okay, kailangan basahin mo. Kung hindi mo naiintindihan, please ipa-translate, ipa-explain mo to somebody who can explain it for you. Hindi yung biglang accept, I understand, accept kaagad. Okay? Know the security features of the social networking site you use by keeping your profile private. Search engines will not be able to scan your profile. Okay? I-try nyo ito. This is true. I-try ninyong i-type yung pangalan ninyo sa Google. Okay? So, kung ano yung lalabas sa Google, yun yung shinare ninyo na public information. Okay? So, kung maraming lumabas about you sa Google when you search your name, ibig sabihin nun, you are at risk. Okay? You are at risk. Okay? Because you have provided most of your private information to the internet na. Okay? At mabilis ka nang makopya, you are a threat, you can be a victim of cybercrime also. Okay? Do not share your password with anyone, kahit pa boyfriend mo o girlfriend mo. It is not advisable that you share your passwords, okay, to your girlfriend or to your boyfriend. Kahit nga mag-asawa, hindi nga minsan karamihan sa mga mag-asawa, they don't know the password of each other. Okay? So please, okay? Share protect yourself also. Yung boyfriend, girlfriend ninyo ay hindi magtatagal, okay? Hindi kayo magtatagal niyan unless talagang you are meant to be. You are meant for each other, okay? But hindi lahat meant for each other, okay? So huwag kayong tanga at i-share niyo talaga yung inyong mga password to your boyfriend or your girlfriend, okay? Huwag kayong mag-ingat kayo, okay? Because they can use that against you, okay? Kayo rin, kawawa rin kayo, di ba? Avoid logging into public networks, Wi-Fi, okay? Especially kung nasa mall kayo, okay? At gumawa kayo ng bank transactions using the internet of the mall, ay naku, naglagot ka na, okay? You are at risk now, okay? As much as possible, use your own personal Wi-Fi or your own data in bank transactions outside. Okay, huwag kayong pupunta sa mall at gagawa ng bank transactions ninyo kasi nakakatakot. Nakakatakot. Okay? You can use it if you will use incognito. Okay, mag-incognito kayo or private mode. Okay? All right? Do not talk to strangers, whether online or face-to-face. Okay? So, huwag kayong basta-basta nakikipag-usap kung kani-kanino na hindi nyo naman kilala. Okay? Especially in the internet, okay? Or even personal or face-to-face. Okay? Lalo na sa face-to-face, nakakatakot din. Okay? Never post anything about your future vacation or it is similar to posting rob my house at this date. Okay? Yung magpo-post kayo na, ay, excited for our family vacation on October 30. Ay, naku. At malaman yan ng mga ibang tao na may interes sa bahay ninyo, sa mga gamit ninyo, sa mga ari-arian ninyo, lagot na kayo. Okay? Sabi nga dito, para mo na rin sinabi na, ay, you are welcome now to rob my house. Pag nakawan niyo na ako, parang ganyan yung sinasabi mo. So, huwag kayong magpo-post. You can post siguro after or going home na nung pag nakauwi na kayo. Okay? Avoid visiting untrusted websites. Kapag sinabi ng if there's a warning na it's not trusted website, please do not continue. Add friends you know in real life. Okay? Add friends you know in real life. Yan yung sinasabi natin, huwag kayong pa-fame, pa-famous, okay? Huwag kayong fame whore, di ba? Yun yung term na sinasabi natin, okay? Huwag tayo basta-bastang nag-a-add ng mga friends natin. Kaya nga, most of you are not yet my friends in Facebook because I don't know you personally yet, okay? Alam ko, estudyante ko kayo. I mean, nakikita ko sa GC, nakikita ko na estudyante ko kayo, but I don't know you yet, so I have to really know you first before I can confirm you, okay? Install and update an antivirus software on your computer. Use only one antivirus software to avoid conflicts, okay? If you have Wi-Fi at home, make it private network by adding a password, okay? Avoid downloading anything from untrusted websites, but the software, do not use pirated ones kasi yun yung mga may kahalo o kaakibat na virus or malware also. Do not reply or click links from suspicious emails. Ah, okay, I'll give you an example of this afterwards. Yung mga hindi naman natin i-expect ng email, okay, yung mga nasa scam na nasa spam pala, I should say, nasa spam area ng email natin. Huwag natin basta-bastang nire-reply yan, ina-acknowledge, okay? At kiniklik, okay? If they are on the spam area. Make online purchases from secure sites only, okay? Yung mga trusted lang, okay? Yung talagang sikat at ginagamit na safe talaga, alright? And then, it says here, hindi porket viral ay totoo at dapat nang share. It's a reminder for you, lalo na kung may personal data na kasama. Okay? So, wag tayong basta-bastang nag-share ng mga information. Okay? Ito, usong-uso noon eh, nung mga panahon ng mga bagyo na walang pasok. Usong-uso ito, yung biglang may magsasabi na wala pa rin pasok until this dates, okay? Huwag tayo nagsashare ng ganun kasi you can be at risk if you do that, okay? You are at risk if you do that, okay? All right. Now, we are now leading to the different internet threats, okay? Which most people would dispute that there is no such thing as private over the internet, okay? And they may be right. Kasi nga, pag nasa internet ka, hindi totoo na pwede mong na private kang tao. Kasi nga, pinunovide mo na eh. Ginamit mo na yung internet eh. Ginamit mo na yung Facebook eh. Ginamit mo na yung IG. So, hindi pwedeng private ka. Yun yung sinasabi nila. Na, which is maybe right. Okay, but some hackers can find a back door even if your profile is already set to private, okay? And you have no control whoever is looking at your friend's screen whenever they open your profile chat with you. So, mag-iingat tayo. Yun yung reminder to all of us, okay? Now, we have here the different internet threats, okay? Here are the threats that you should be aware when using the internet. First, we have the malware, okay, or the malicious software. What is this? This is any program or file that is harmful to a computer user, okay? Ano yung malware sinasabi natin? We have first the virus, okay? Alam niyo itong virus na ito, a malicious program designed to replicate itself, okay, and transfer from one computer into another, okay, they can be transferred through internet, through local networks, through FDs, flash drives, or CD drives, and others. So, kung pwede silang lumipat, pwede silang mag-transfer from the different forms, from the internet, from local networks, from flash drive, from CD drives, and many other forms pa. Okay? So, it can replicate anong ginagawa niya sa atin, sa file mo, it replicates. Okay? Sinisira niya. Okay? Kaya nga, kung papansin ninyo, kapag na virusan yung flash drive din nyo, or yung akala ninyong USB, ang USB po, hindi yan yung USB na stick na ginagamit natin, that is not USB, that is called flash drive, okay? Ang USB is the one being used in that flash drive, okay? So, yung parang pinaka-port niya, pinaka-bunganga niya, yun yung tinatawag na USB, okay? So, one example of malware is virus, okay? Second one is the worm. Okay? It's a malicious program that transfers also from one computer to another by any type of means. Okay? An example of the famous worm is the I Love You Worm. Okay? The malware originated in Pandacan neighborhood of Manila in the Philippines on May 5, 2000. Okay? Yan yung pinaka tingnan niyo, galing talaga ng Pilipinas, ano? Talaga kalakohan eh, Pilipina din, ano? Alright? And then we also have a Trojan, okay? Alam niyo naman siguro itong Trojan. It is a malicious program that disguises as a useful program. Nagpapanggap na akala mo parang okay na program siya. But once downloaded or installed, it leaves your PC unprotected and allows now the hackers to get your information. So, nakakatakot. Kaya nga kailangan mag-ingat-ingat tayo when using the internet. Okay? Because we have the different types of the malware. Okay? And then, we also have the spyware. Okay? Ano to? It's a program that runs in the background without you knowing it. Kaya nga spy eh. Di ba? So, hindi mo alam, naka-open ka na pala ng spyware, hindi mo alam na kinokopya na yung information, especially kung meron kang bank transaction sa PC mo, kinakopya niya na. Nakopya na niya yung password mo, yung account mo, then transfer na yung pera mo from his account. Diba? So, delikado ka. Okay? Because itong spyware talaga, hindi mo makikita because it runs in the background. Eh. Hindi mo siya alam na nag-degenerate na pala siya. It has the ability to monitor what you are currently doing and typing through key logging. Ayan. Example of spyware is the key logger, okay? Used to record keystrokes done by the user. This is done to steal their password or any other sensitive information. O, yan na, yung account mo, yung account number mo, yung PIN mo sa account mo, bank account mo, okay? Yun yung ginagawa ng spyware or the keylogger. The keylogger software typically uses log file to store its recording. So, dire-record niya lahat ng information, lahat ng mga ginawa mo, lahat ng mga transaction mo during that time. Okay? An adware also, okay, next is the adware, which is a program again designed to send you advertisements mostly as pop-ups. Yung biglang magpa-pop up na ganyan na ano to na when you open the Google Chrome, 'di ba? Minsan pag nakapag-open tayo ng website, biglang may magpa-pop up na patalastas. Adware ang tawag doon. I-close niyo kaagad. Kakatakot din 'yon. It's a threat also. Okay? Then we also have the ransomware. Or ransomware software is a type of malicious software from cryptovirology that threatens to publish the victim's data or perpetually block access to it unless a ransom is paid. So, ayan niya, ransomware. Yung kukunin niya yung information mo, ibablock ka from using that, and then kailangan kukunin nila yung account mo, and then bayaran mo kung gusto mong makuha, di ba? So, nakakatakot. Pag hinimingi ng 5 million, eh, kailangan bayaran mo. Diba? Kasi it's an information about you. So, nakakatakot talaga. Right? Then, we also have the number 2, which is the spam. Ito na yung sinasabi ko kanina, an unwanted email, mostly from bots or advertisers. It can be used to send malware. Kaya mag-ingat kayo. Okay? Baka akala nyo, it's a typical email, yun pala, it has a malware na, okay? Or any malware, ang dami natin different types dyan, di ba? We have 5. So, malay mo, isa doon contains the malware, di ba? So, nakakatakot. Then, we have the third one, which is phishing. Its goal is to acquire sensitive personal information like passwords and credit card details. This is done by sending you an email that will direct the user to visit a fake website and be asked to update his or her username, password, credit card, or personal information. So, nakakatakot din. Okay? Yan din ang isa sa mga nakakatakot na internet threat. Okay? I'll give you an example of what we're talking now. Okay, ayan. This is published and I got this picture from the DICT, Cybersecurity Bureau. Kapag nakatanggap ka ba ng email galing sa Netflix, sa mga bangko, sa mga boss mo, sa IT department, ang opisina mo, sa Lazada, o kaya naman sa SSS, marunong ka bang sumuri kung lehitimo ito o hindi. Oh. So, can you determine whether an email is legit? Okay? Marunong ka bang mag-determine? Baka mamaya na phishing ka na, nasimot na lahat ng pera mo. Oo, nakakatakot. Ayan, huwag mascam. Iba na ang may alam. Okay? So, we have here an example. Ito, galing naman daw sa Netflix team. Nagpanggap silang Netflix team. Ayan. It says, we recently failed to validate your Netflix payment information. In order to continue your subscription with our service, you need to check and revalidate your information on the link below. O meron nakalagay na www.netflix.com/verification. Failure to complete this process will send result to Netflix ban and you might not be able to sign up in the future. Oh, thank you for understanding, Christy Anderson, sabi naman. Okay? Another example of a phishing or a threat from the BPI naman siya. Okay? It says, dear valued client, greetings from BPI Express Online. Please be advised that we have deactivated the access of your account or accounts in BPI Express Online. It is usually pretty easy to take care of things like this. Most of the time, we just need a little more information about your account or latest transactions. You can verify your account at bpi.express.online. Okay? These communication channels are available to you 24 hours a day a week. Thank you for banking and online. Ayan. Okay. What do you think of this? Is this a legit email from BPI or not? In order to know, okay, if an email, okay, is legit or not, okay? First, tignan ang email address ng nagpadala. Hindi ito katulad ng official na email address ng BPI. Okay? Maging mapanuri also. Okay? Tignan kung paano ang pagkasalaysay ng nilalaman ng email. Tandaan, ang bangko ay isang formal na institusyon. Pangatlo, huwag basta-bastang kumindot ng mga external link bago o maaari mong i-hover ang iyong mouse or tapat ng salita o imaheng may link upang makita ang tunay na link nito. Ibig sabihin, ilagay mo yung itapat mo yung mouse mo, okay, on the link na binigay nila in the email. Huwag basta-bastang kumindot. Okay? Hindi maglalagay ang isang bangko o anumang korporasyon ng isang prepaid na numero para sa kanyang contact detail. Ayan. Oh, it says 0929-35396. O, di ba? 39688. Ayan. So, hindi nagbibigay ng personal number ang bangko or any other corporation. Now, meron tayong tinatawag na phishing. Okay, aside from phishing, meron tayong tinatawag na phishing. Ano itong phishing na to? Ang phishing o voice phishing ay isang uri ng panlulokong ginagawa sa pamamagitan ng telepono. Layunin itong makakuha ng personal, sensitibo o pinansyal na impormasyon sa binibiktimang kausap. Okay? O kunwari, this is your bank. Your account has been compromised. We will need you to provide with us your information to reset your password. Ay, nakakatakot na yan. Isang halimbawa ng phishing ay ang pagpapanggap ng caller na siya ay mula sa bangko kung saan may account ang tinatawagan. Magkukunwaring nakompromiso ang account ng biktima at hihingan siya ng sensitibong impormasyon. Okay? Huwag basta maniwala at maging maingat sa pagbibigay ng anumang impormasyon. Okay? All right. So, protecting, how will you protect yourself in the internet or online. Okay, here are the things that you might want to consider before posting something over the internet. First, before you post something on the web, ask these questions to yourself. First, would you want your parents or grandparents to see it? Okay? Gusto mo bang makita ng parents mo or ng grandparents mo or ng mga tito at tita mo or anybody in your family members yung pinos mong yun? Would you want your future boss to see it? Kasi nga, ang latest trend ngayon when you apply for a work, chine-check, bina-background check ka na, hindi from the persons which you provided information. Yung may mga character references kasing ipaprovide eh. So, hindi na dun. May mga background investigation na rin sa mga pinopost natin sa Facebook. So, kung ano-ano ang pinopost mo, about terrorism, about nonsense things ang pinopost mo sa account mo, sa yung social media accounts, that's a big no-no to the company. So, gusto mo ba na makita ng future boss mo yung mga pinagpo-post mo? Ba? If you feel that a post can affect you or others' reputation, ask the one who posted it to pull it down or report it as inappropriate. Kung alam mo na hindi makabubuti sa'yo at it will affect your reputation or others' reputation, pwede mong hingin sabihan yung nag-post na tanggalin yun. Okay? Or kung ayaw, you can report it as inappropriate. Okay? Right. So I got an information also here from the DICT page, okay? An internet etiquette for safer and better online environment. Okay? First, don't publish personal information. Okay? Second, be selective when adding friends. Ayan. So you learn from me. Okay? Huwag kayong basta-basta nag-add ng mga friends and di nyo naman kilalain. Okay? Know the privacy settings of your social media accounts. Okay? Stop and think before you click. Okay? Huwag kayong basta-basta click ng click, send ng send. Diba? Kaya kayo napapagalitan, kaya kayo natatanggal sa GC. Kasi kung ano-ano mga pinapost ninyo. Diba? And then, part 2 of it, okay, choose strong and hard to guess passwords. Okay? Ang sabi nila, the minimum. The minimum months ng pag-reset mo dapat ng password is every after 3 months. Okay? So you make sure na strong at mahirap hulaan yung password ninyo. Okay? Kasi uso ngayon na nag-hack. Okay? Haluan nyo ng mga numbers and other characters and then lagyan nyo ng capital letters and small letters. Verify applications before installing. Wag mo, check nyo muna kung is it safe? Okay? Is it okay? Hindi ka ba at risk them sa application na yon, okay, before installing it. Don't upload inappropriate photos, especially yung mga topless na photos ninyo, yung pa-sexy na photos ninyo, you might not know, parang katulad nung nangyari doon sa baby, nagamit na siya in a porn site or porn group, pornography group, okay? Please, okay? No to fake news. Ayan. Okay? Be aware of the facts before posting or sharing information. Okay? Ito yung lagi kong pinapaalala sa mga former students ko. Okay? Let's not share fake news. Okay? Maging mapanuri muna tayo. Let's identify and let's review first and mag-research tayo if the information is really true. If not, then please don't share it anymore. Or if somebody have shared it, you correct them, okay? I-correct mo sila. Remember, spreading fake news is a crime, okay? Ayan, I got this from the DICT page also. Republic Act number 11469, Section 6, penalizes those individuals or group creating or perpetrating or spreading false information regarding the COVID-19 or any other fake news, okay, on social media and other platforms such as information having no valid or beneficial effect on the population and others, okay? So please, wag kayong basta-basta nag-share, okay? Because spreading fake news is a crime. And of course, you have to remember this, although this one will be explained more to you, okay? On the copyright infringement, okay? Copyright infringement is the use of works protected by copyright law. Ibig sabihin, may nagmamay-ari doon at hindi siya basta-bastang pwedeng kunin, gamitin, especially for business, okay? Where such permission is required also, okay? Here are some tips that could help you avoid copyright infringement. First, always assume that the work is copyrighted. Okay, lagi niyo tandaan na lahat ng mga kinukuha niyo from the internet ay copyrighted. Okay, assume niyo. Okay, isipin niyo parang ipagpalagay ninyo na it is copyrighted so that hindi kayo pahama. Okay, do not copy, share, or alter without seeking permission also. Okay? Hindi kayo bigla niyong pinagbago yung mga information na wala na aside from the pinalitan yung pangalan, tapos pinagin yung mga pangalan, delikado kayo dyan. Review and retain licensing agreements, consider buying consent, and give credit to the original author or the page or information. So, always do that. That's just like what I'm doing now. Okay? Remember to stay safe online, be responsible internet user, think before you click, always and always. I hope you learned something from this video, and if not, give me a message on the group Facebook group chat, okay? I will explain to you yung mga gagawin ninyo in your module, yung mga activities niyo on a separate video. Thank you.